हेलो।
तो हितेश एंड वेदांत आर रेडी। तुम लोग दोनों रेडी हो क्या? तो
यस मैम।
कपिल, तुम एक काम करो, तुम्हारा पार्ट तुम कल प्रेजेंट करो। आज वेदांत और हितेश रेडी है ना, तो लेट देम गिव। ठीक है? हाँ,
ओके ओके मैम। ओके
ठीक है वेदांत, यू कैन स्टार्ट। आई जस्ट स्टॉप शेयरिंग।
ऑडियो
यस 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 यस
गुड आफ्टरनून, गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन। सो आवर टॉपिक इज अबाउट दिस स्पेस एक्स। तो वेदांत चेंज द स्लाइड्स एंड आवर टीममेट्स आर मी माय सेल्फ हितेश कपिल एंड वेदांत। तो आई विल बी ब्रीफिंग यू अबाउट द इंट्रोडक्शन एंड अबाउट द इलॉन मस्क। नेक्स्ट स्लाइड। So, introduction to SpaceX. Well, we everyone know that SpaceX is basically a private organization, which is what to say, making the satellites and which is launching the spacecrafts and everything. So, many of us don't know what is the full form of the SpaceX. It is an abbreviation for Space Exploration Technologies Corporation, and it was founded in 2002. And it changed the what to say era of the commercial space life. We will be talking about much more in deep. So basically, what was the aim? Previous slide. Yeah. What was the aim? It came to revolutionize the aerospace industry and making the affordable spacecraft a reality. Basically, the Elon Musk has the dream that a common man or we can say normal human being should also go to the Mars and he should also explore what actually is there in the space and everything. So with that dream, he initiated the SpaceX company. So we will be looking forward what were the achievements they have completed. So it was founded on 6th May 2002 with the goal of reducing space transportation cost to enable the colonization of Mars. And the SpaceX manufactures the Falcon 9 and Falcon Heavy launch vehicles, several rocket engines, Dragon, cargo, and Crew spacecraft and Starlink, and these are the names of the spacecraft and whatever the engines they have launched. We in the further slides we will be explaining how they are designed and how they are working. Next slide. So about the Elon Musk, basically we everyone know how legend person he is. Means from the childhood itself he was having a very much great IQ, and with a further what was exploring the knowledge, he started thinking like he should do something different. And so he started creating many opportunities like PayPal, then SpaceX, then Neuralink, OpenAI, then multiple different streams he opened. So in 2002, the very first he started the SpaceX, where he is currently the CEO and the CTO. CTO is nothing but Chief Technology Officer. And in 2004, he joined electric vehicle manufacturing company that is nothing but Tesla. And we everyone know how people are crazy about the Tesla, about the function, each and everything about the Tesla company. And in 2006, he created another company named as Solar City, which is a solar based service company. And it is also helping the Tesla company along with its subsidiary. And in 2015, he co-founded the OpenAI, which is again a company which is non-government, non-profit company, which is basically working on the artificial intelligence. And in 2016, he co-founded Neuralink, a neurotechnology company based, which is developing chips from which the person can interact with the human brain directly using a small chip. Basically, I will give an example. What he did is a small fig, a brain. He inserted a chip so that he can track the brain is sensing of that fig. So this was the one of the example, and many more things they are doing in that Neuralink company. And also he is running an hyperloop vector and transportation system, which is under the development. Next slide, Vedant. तो या इट इज एन अमेरिकन कंपनी विच इज हेडक्वार्टर्ड इन हाउथोरन कैलिफोर्निया एंड दिस स्पेस एक्स अचीवमेंट्स इंक्लूड द फर्स्ट प्राइवेटली फंडेड लिक्विड प्रोपेलेंट रॉकेट टू रीच द ऑर्बिट विच इज नथिंग बट नेम्ड एज फाल्कन 1 एंड इट वॉज लॉन्च इन 2008 एंड इट वॉज द फर्स्ट कंपनी सक्सेसफुली लॉन्च ऑर्बिट एंड रिकवर स्पेस क्राफ्ट एंड दैट वॉज अगेन इन द 2010 दैट इज नथिंग बट अ ड्रैगन एंड अगेन इन 2012 एंड अगेन द फाल्कन 9 इन 2015 एंड 2017 एंड मेनी मोर इंजन्स लाइक वी कैन से दैट ड्रैगन डेमो 2 एंड द स्पेस एक्स क्रू 1 मिशंस इन 2020 ऑल्सो एंड द फाल्कन 9 सीरीज इज वन ऑफ द मोस्ट इम्पोर्टेंट सीरीज ऑफ द रॉकेट इंजन्स डेवलप्ड बाय द स्पेस एक्स विच इज बीन व्हाट टू से लॉन्च बाय मोर देन ओवर 100 टाइम्स. What it does is basically developing a large internet satellite constellation named the Starlink. Starlink is the name given to this internet satellites. In January 2020, the Starlink constellation became the largest satellite constellation in the world. Yeah, because the functions and each and everything they were designed were so appropriate that it was also used by the NASA and the other government defense officials. And it is also developing a Starship, a private funded super heavy lift launch system for interplanetary space life. Basically, we also know that whenever the rockets or any spaceships are launched, so there has to be some launching system from which the rockets are emerging. So Starship is nothing but that only from which the rockets are emerged and they are successfully launched into the orbit. And Starship is included to become the primary SpaceX orbital vehicle once operational, supplanting the existing Falcon 9, Falcon Heavy and Dragon fleet. Currently, the Falcon and the Heavy Dragon fleet are the in the operation for the orbital launch vehicle. Very soon, it will be replaced with the Starship and yeah, they are working on it. And the most important why they are replacing it because the Starship is fully reusable. And also the capacity of the payload of the Starship is much higher than as compared to the Falcon Heavy and the Dragon fleet. With the next slide. So we will be looking year by year from when they founded and what do they have achieved by year by year. So in 2001, the idea came into the mind of the Elon Musk to so that that we should grow the plants on Mars as well. So what to say? So he initiated that idea in the mind and then he worked on it and he announced that further life should be traveled, like many common man, the human being, normal human being should also travel to the space. So what he thought that I should purchase some cheap rockets from the Russia, then I in affordable price, and then should I develop it, and then should I launch it to the Mars. But when he tried to purchase the rocket, he saw that the prices were not that he can buy. So after doing so much of research, he found that the actual price of the rocket, the selling price, were much higher. The actual cost was only 3% of the what they were trying to sell. So what he did, he purchased the raw material and he started building his own engines and satellites, everything machine by in his own company, and he named that as SpaceX. He hired the one rocket engineer named as Tom Mueller, and he also invited to become him a business partner, and the Tom Mueller also agreed to work with the Musk, and they formed the SpaceX, and everyone know that how they have achieved so many tasks and every they have they have launched so many satellites and engines in further years, and they started with the 160 employees. Next slide, Vedant. Now the Vedant will be explaining so how they have achieved each and everything and how the rocket's engine were developed and how in which year they were launched. Yeah, Vedant, over to you.
Okay, so after that, after founding for about 6 years, the company went nowhere, See, just like we have an ISRO, if any company wants to, in this sector, wants to grow big, they need government contracts. Otherwise, there is no source of income. So until you show some results, you won't get the contract, and a startup won't get the contract. Earlier established companies are Boeing, which used to always get NASA's contracts for refilling the International Space Station. So until 2008, this is what they did to get their first success in 2008. So with the seed fund about $90 million, the Falcon 1 was developed. It was only a two-stage rocket to land the satellite into an orbit, and it was a small lift. So we see ISRO does not use small lift. They at one time they launch hundreds of satellites. I think that record also was broken by SpaceX in the last 2-3 months ago when they made a launch. They broke ISRO's record. But it all started with sending small lift orbit vehicles first, launch vehicle. So in 2005, what they did is they started their own commercial space program to get funding. So see, just like you go to take a visa and go to another country, they started selling tickets that when they will develop fully, they will send you, means whoever is the ticket purchaser, into space, just for space tourism, no exploration, just tourism, go there and look at the Earth. So in 2006, after raising some funds, they put together a crew and started demonstrating that they could actually supply cargo to the International Space Station. So Falcon 1, US Department of Defense, they purchased prototypes of it. Half was it to fund SpaceX, and some was the proprietary technology which SpaceX was developing. They wanted to understand and test it on their own. So that's why they purchased. So DARP is nothing but the defense organization. It was played a crucial role in developing the internet also 40-50 years ago. So the first three launches, they were successful until the major breakthrough in 2008. The Falcon 1 was again successful second time, which got SpaceX thinking about larger orbital rockets. So in this decade, what they have done is first they started developing separately. Now Dragon, but in this previous 5 years, they are trying to do vertical integration. What vertical integration basically means is when you buy a computer from Dell, this from other company, this from other company, so your costs run out of the budget. So vertical integration means you develop the rocket yourself, you develop the propulsion system yourself, you develop the launch system yourself. So that time, that way you can streamline the cost. That is called as vertical integration. So for Falcon 1, it is an intermediate capacity, not high capacity, not low capacity. All the way up to Falcon 5 they have developed. So now Falcon 9 is reusable heavier lift vehicle. What that means is, see, when you launch a satellite, the rocket, after extinguishing all its fuel, it falls down. Generally, it is aimed at the sea or a desert, desolate place, so nothing is harmed. But this has a lot of cost. Imagine if you took a plane and every time you has to, somebody just muted me, so has to be destroyed. So that increases the cost. But the major breakthrough of SpaceX is they are providing reusable launch vehicles, which ISRO has planned but still not materialized into developing. So in 2008 they got the contract about a little less than $300 US million from the government to develop Falcon 9 along with Dragon. So what is Dragon, we'll see later. As part of this contract, they provided, in 2 years they provided Dragon spacecraft qualification unit. So the first operation Dragon spacecraft was launched in 2010. So you can see that first from 2005 to 2010, from proposal to actually developing it took 5 years. So similarly, ISRO may take 5 years more or less. Now they are also thinking about making reusable rockets. So 2 times it returned successfully, this Dragon spacecraft. In 2010, a new production line, which I talked about, vertical integration for Falcon's spacecraft was developed for developing new Falcons every 3 months. Coming to this decade again, for the second time, so second round commercial crew development. So this is into developing commercial, actually this is Kapil's part, so I think I will leave it for him.
Yeah, Vedant, you can go ahead.
So the launch vehicles we saw earlier, that now it is trying to retire all these launch vehicles separate, Falcons, Dragons, and instead integrate them into Starship. What is Starship? We will see. So after it docked, the Dragon spacecraft docked into the ISS and it refilled it and came back and landed safely. Then the first version of Dragon was used only for cargo. So if it gets destroyed or something, there is no human arm. So after Dragon was tested, now they are planning to send humans. But before that, what he did was put a Tesla and launched it into orbit. So that Tesla is a Tesla car and it is on a satellite, and that satellite is now orbiting around the sun. I don't know, just to show that they can do it. So it has about three ton carrying capacity. It took 3 tons of that is this capacity, and it took that much to the space station for its crew, food or other experiment material. So they had to isolate it, means to prevent heat damage from the sensitive scientific material. They also provided insulation service inside the Dragon spacecraft. So suddenly it is about 1/5 increase in the capacity. So you can do the calculation, 3 tons increased by 20%. So these are some pictures how it looks like. This is the Dragon spacecraft. Now drone ships is interesting. For this they have partnered with Amazon. So when you order something from Amazon, a person comes to deliver. In some countries with low population density, they are actually doing the deliveries with drones. So what can SpaceX do about that? Instead of using rotators to fly those drones, SpaceX is providing their rocket technology which they have developed. So the propellant margins, means basically the cost of the fuel, propellant. Return to launch site. So after delivering the goods, the satellite can come back and land. So if the landing is happening and on sea, it cannot land on water. So floating launch pads are provided on the ocean on which the rocket can land. And autonomous spaceport drone ships is another thing they are developing. Now oil rigs are there in Norway and other countries. They have extracted all the oil they could get. Now the rigs are just standing there on the sea, so with no output. So they are planning to use those redundant rigs as landing platforms. Some risk is there that if there is actually some oil remaining and if it lands and catches fire, that is a high risk. But it is better than building your own launch platform on the ocean yourself. So super heavy boosters, this is another proprietary technology which they have developed. Now they are trying to integrate it into Starship second stage. Now they have already purchased two deep water oil rigs for launching and refitting. See, this is an oil rig. Actually, it was an oil rig, so they have refitted it as a launching and landing platform. What is Starship? So now until this, they were using for a small weight set, means launch vehicles. They were just like we have PSLV launch vehicles. The reusable technology they had made available for small launch vehicles. Now they are using it for super heavy lift launch vehicles. It is named as Starship. So first stage is called as super heavy. The reusable is the only reusable part is only the second stage. The system is intended to replace all the company's earlier services, which I mentioned, Dragon, Falcon, everything, streamline it into Starship. So these are all the technical details, 12 meter diameter ITS concept in 2016, which was solely aimed at Mars transit and other interplanetary use. So the motto, just like Cheyenne Anchor Kutch Engineering College has a mission and vision statement, the same thing for SpaceX is to make humanity an interplanetary species. So Earth orbit, they have to study. They have to study the lunar orbit, also the Mars orbit. That is only in the conceptual phase. They have not done that much study of the lunar orbit, according to the information available. So, but it is necessary for interplanetary missions and also for intercontinental passenger transport to Earth. What this means is, just like a plane, but that plane goes to space and lands back in another continent on the Earth. For that, definitely we need reusable vehicles, because just like a plane, you don't want to make a new plane every time you want to fly a plane. So the large components on Starship are made of stainless steel. That is the main material. This is a Japanese scientist. Japanese Vedan. Person. Yes, ma'am.
Vedan, don't go into so much of depth. Just you can say some important points, right? Like okay. You just now said, ki, yeah. Okay, so interplanetary, intercontinental use and everything. Okay, and the last I think point is very important, right? That by 2035, wala, right?
Yes, ma'am. They have planned that they want to see million people, just like we have millions of people using airplanes today. They propose that millions of people will be using space travel by 2035, that is in 15 years from now. So this is how the Starship looks. Starlink is just like we have Jio Internet or other companies of internet, and Google has its Cloud Loom. What they want to do is send satellites instead of one big satellite, which for InSat we have, or Navik we have, or for entire India. They want to send small thousands of satellites, but this has been criticized heavily because it will increase space debris. So there is the runaway effect. See, if one satellite, small satellite, malfunctions and crashes into another, it starts a chain reaction of small satellites crashing into each other and disabling and creating, making the space basically unusable for other countries, other companies. And also for astronomers who observe, the space because they only see the debris and not the actual stars. That's it from my side.
Very nice presentation, Hitesh and Vedant. And I exactly wanted these things from you guys because over here, I don't know how many students are actually listening to this presentation. If some of you are not paying attention to this information that you are reaping out from this presentation, then you are at your loss because no one is going to check and see on SpaceX website that what Elon Musk has done in his life and how he has come through from his journey to till date of SpaceX. So really very nice presentation and I'm keen to know how what Kapil is going to present tomorrow. And one more thing I want to add over here in this presentation that there was a time ki when Elon Musk earlier designed, we know PayPal he designed and so many other applications he designed. And when he actually started investing into space organizations, at that particular point of time, when he said, ki, yes, I want to do it. Okay. I want to make a company who will take millions of people into space and it will make traveling to space normal. Right. So there was one point when he actually lost everything. Okay. His company was into debt. Okay. His investors were doubting on him now. Now they were just about to take out their all the stakes from his company and just leave. Okay. And at that particular point of time, Elon Musk sat with his wife and they decided, now let's just take everything what we have to stake. Okay. They sold their house. They sold their cars. They sold every bits and pieces that they had in one night. Okay. And they were actually on the road on that day. Okay. And he generated some amount from his own funds by selling his house and everything what he had. And by seeing him doing that, because it was his baby, the company was his baby. So by seeing him doing that, his stakeholders, they got the encouragement and enthusiasm from him. Ki agar ye kar sakta hai, toh hum kyun nahi kar sakte? So in that one night, all the stakeholders, they also gave everything what they had and they saved their company. And in just within 10 days, the stock market of SpaceX shooted so high that it broke all the records up till now and in any other and all the stock stakeholders and all the shareholders, all those people got a boost and finally SpaceX survived. And after that there was no one and there is no one right now to stop SpaceX from achieving whatever their mission is. Okay, so this was, you can if you can go to YouTube and you see a video, Elon Musk interview is there. In that he has told all these things, how his journey has turned up to this particular thing. It's a great story. You can go and see it. Okay, that's all for today. I'll just download the attendance. After that, you can leave.